ये श्री भक्ति वेदांत स्वामी श्रील प्रभुपाद की जय। जय शुभा परमहंस परिव्राजकाचार्य स्तोत्रस्तु श्री श्रीमद भक्ति सिद्धांत सरस्वती गोस्वामी ठाकुर श्रील प्रभुपाद की जय। अनंत कोटि वैष्णव वृंद की जय। प्रेम से कहो श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासदी गौर भक्त वृंद की जय। श्री श्री राधा कृष्ण गोप गोपी गौ श्याम कुंड राधा कुंड गिरि गोवर्धन की जय। गोपाष्टमी की जय। समवेत भक्त वृंद की जय। श्री श्री गुरु गौरांग की जय। ओम ज्ञान अतिमरंदस्य ज्ञानञ्जनशलाखया चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः। वन्देऽहं श्रीगुरो श्रीयुतपदकमलं श्रीगुरोन् वैष्णवांश्च श्रीरूपं सागरजातं सहगणरघुनाथान्वितं तं सदीपं साद्वैतं सावधूतं परिजनसहितं कृष्णचैतन्यदेवं श्रीराधाकृष्णपादान् सहगणललिता श्री विशाखान्वितांश। जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासदि गौरभक्तवृंद। हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम राम राम। हरे कृष्ण। Someone has to translate. I don't know. Today is Gopashtami, so we will. Gopashtami is a day commemorating Krishna becoming a full-fledged Gopa. Full-fledged Gopa means, before he was taking care of calves, small calves, and on this day he started taking care of cows. So that is the day of Gopashtami. So on this day I would like to take opportunity to speak on the topic challenges in cow protection today. That is the topic. So challenges, what are the challenges in cow protection in today's world? First and foremost problem is, for every problem that is a problem, is philosophical problem. Philosophical understanding of the importance of cow protection. Or we can say it is a theological problem. So also, why theological problem? Because the Supreme Personality of Godhead, theology means, you see, it is connected with God. So we don't know who is God and what he does. So therefore it is a theological problem also. I'll come to this point. So when we speak about philosophical or theological problem, basically we don't know the importance of cow protection, how cow is important in human society. So often we discuss that how this present society is not a human society. It's a animal. So Prabhupada used many different words, phrases in describing today's world as animal society, misdirected civilization, misdirected society, sometime rascal society, demonic society. So he used a different society of cats and dogs, hawks and dogs, because human beings have become animals. So what is the importance of cow protection in human society? So Srila Prabhupada says that there is no human civilization without cow protection.
So different way he explained, like in a civilized society there would be protection of five things. It is said in the Shastra, cows, brahmanas, women, children and elderly people. So they should be protected. So if there are if there is no protection of these five things, it is not a human civilization or a human society. It is a degraded society. It is. So cows, apart from the fact, like I mentioned, theological point problem, that we don't understand that God is a coward boy. Who is God? God is a Vraja Gopa. He is a coward boy of Vrindavan. So Supreme Personality of Godhead, what is he doing in the in his abode? He is tending cows. Surabhi Rabhi Palayantam, we hear in Brahma Samhita. Venum Konantam Aravinda Dalayataksham Barhavatam Samasitambuda Sundarangam Kandarpa Koti Kamaniya Vishesha Shobam Govindamada Adipurusham Tama. Oh, that is another verse. Angani yasya sakalendriya vrittivanti pashyanti panti kalayanti chiram jaganti. Anyway, I am getting mixed up here. Whatever that word is there, Surabhir Abhipalayantam. So, Chintamaniya. Chintamani prakara sadma shukalpa vaksha laksha vratesh Surabhir Abhipalayantam. Yeah, so this is the verse. So, so that is Chintamani Dham. So, what is he doing in the in his abode? So he is playing on flute, he is dancing with the gopis and he is tending cows. Surabhi Rabhi Palayantam. So that is one of his main functions, or it is the main thing what Krishna does in. Of course, we may have ontologically this can be challenged and it can be debated, but like some may say that no, Rasa Leela is the most important thing Krishna does. So it is, can be debatable. That is a different topic altogether. So there can be many ontological debates, which is the better pastime of Krishna. So, but whatever he does, what is he doing in the Goloka Vrindavan? He is tending cows. And the very name Goloka or Gokula is also connected with cows. Gokula. Gokula means it's a place of cows. Goloka, world of cows. That is the meaning of these words. And recently we had Govardhana festival. That Govardhana, it is the name of that hill which Krishna lifted. But what is the meaning of the Govardhana? So Govardhana means one who nourishes the cows. Such. So Govardhana is one who nourishes the cows. So everything is connected with cows, cows. So people in general in the world, they don't know about God. Who is God? So in modern days, they are debating whether God exists or not. That is what to speak of understanding who is God. So that is a different topic altogether. But even among devotees who chant Krishna, 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 they don't know who is God. So I often tell that this is a theological problem within ISKCON also, among devotees also, that they don't understand whom they are calling it. So he is a coward boy. So, and when he appears in this world, what he does? So he just appeared within a moment, within few moment, within short time, he left from Mathura to Gokul. He went to Gokul and he was doing cow protection by his personal example. So in third chapter of Bhagavad Gita, we see that Krishna says that by my example, I teach the world about following dharma, what we are supposed to do in human life. So Krishna is a symbol of cow protection, Prabhupada said, and Balaram is symbol of farming, agriculture. So both Krishna and Balaram are farm acharyas, Prabhupada he says. So by his example, acharya means by his example he teaches. So in third chapter, Krishna says in Bhagavad Gita that if I don't follow dharma, then whole world will follow my example and whole world would be ruined. So we can see that present world, it's all ruined. Everything is ruined. It is. So apart from this theological misconceptions, misunderstanding, so even people in general, from materialistic point of material point of view also, people don't understand the importance of cow milk. Oh, before that, I would also like to discuss how cows are very important in human society. Prabhupada says that human society begins with Varnashrama, so Vedic civilization. And Vedic civilization, human society begins with cow, Vedic Varnashrama, so our Vedic civilization. And with Vedic civilization, which we means Varnashrama Dharma or Dharmic tradition, so the main thing in dharma, so there cannot be dharma without cow protection. So in Vedic dharma, every activity is connected with cow. So every item, every limb of dharma is connected with cow protection. There cannot be dharma without cows. So even in bhakti, we see in deity worship, we need to offer Krishna cow milk. We have to offer him butter. Krishna is butter thief. So there cannot be any religious activity without cow protection. Of course, some of our Gaudiyas may say that in this age, only chanting Hare Krishna, we don't need cows. We don't need to do deity worship. Main thing is chanting Hare Krishna. Oh, that is another big lecture. Why? Hare Nama, Hare Nama, Hare Nama, Iva Kevalam. Like that, we may quote that verse. It is true, definitely, chanting Hare Krishna. Without chanting Hare Krishna, no other religious activity or devotional activity will give result in this age. That is true, but that doesn't mean we only do chanting Hare Krishna. So we eat, right? When we eat, then we need deities, right? We have to offer it to Krishna, right? So we need, we sleep, we mate. Most of the people need sex life, and we need defense. So all these things, if we have to spiritualize them or do them in a religious way, then we need dharma, we need other devotional activities apart from chanting Hare Krishna. So then all those things are get connected with cow protection. So in this way, so there is no dharmic activity without cows. So everything is connected with the cows. Like just one example I would give you. So we perform, when we are doing Diksha ceremony or we are doing Vivaha Samskara, so then we perform sacrifices. So that Yajna Kunda is all, it should be made with cow dung. So cow dung and cow urine is required there. So like that, everything is, in fact, every day if you want to do deity worship, every day Lord is bathed with cow dung actually. Abhishek of the Lord is done with cow dung. So there is no religious activity. Therefore, those who are followers of dharmic traditions, those who are followers of Vedic civilization, they always protected cows. So ultimately, it is connected with Krishna, because the purpose of dharma is to, Prabhupada used to tell, purpose of religion is to know God and love God. So if we want to be lovers of God, then we have to know what He likes, what He doesn't like, right? सो कृष्णा लव्स काउस, सो देयर फॉर दे आर वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. सो वी डोंट अंडरस्टैंड द इम्पॉर्टेंस ऑफ काउस. एंड अपार्ट फ्रॉम दैट, इवन फ्रॉम फिजिकल पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू, हाउ काउ मिल्क इज सो इम्पॉर्टेंट फॉर ह्यूमन बॉडी. नाउ वेगनिज्म इज वेरी हेविली टेकिंग ओवर द वर्ल्ड. सो देर आर सो मेनी बोगस थिंग्स आर कमिंग अप, दिस इज़म दैट इज़म, सो मेनी इज़म्स एवरी डे दे कॉक्ट. सो बट वी सी फ्रॉम द शास्त्रा दैट काउ मिल्क इज प्रॉपर कॉल्ड इट एज मिरेकल फूड. वाई मिरेकल फूड? बिकॉज इन भगवद्गीता कृष्ण ही स्पीक्स अबाउट पर्पज ऑफ ईटिंग फूड. वाई वी ईट फूड? ही सेज आयु सत फूड शुड इंक्रीज लॉन्गिविटी, इट शुड प्यूरिफाई हार्ट एंड माइंड, एंड इट शुड गिव अस फिजिकल स्ट्रेंथ, इट शुड गिव अस हेल्थ, हैप्पीनेस एंड सेटिस्फैक्शन. आयु सत्व बलारोग्य सुख प्रीति विवर्धन, कृष्ण से विवर्धन मीन्स इट शुड एनहेंस. सो दैट इज द पर्पज ऑफ ईटिंग फूड. सो अमंग ऑल द फूड आइटम्स दिस काउ मिल्क गिवज दीज रिजल्ट इन हाइएस्ट डिग्री, देयर फॉर इट इज कॉल्ड एज मिराकल फूड. सो इवन फ्रॉम फिजिकल पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू एंड इकोनॉमिक पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू, so the importance of cows is not understood. So therefore this is called that's why I called it as philosophical problem. So we can call it as ignorance also. So Prabhupada, he says, now among devotees also we are doing bhakti, devotional service, but if we don't understand all these things, then we become like that, our bhakti becomes sentimental. So because philosophically if you don't understand bhakti, then what? Prabhupada, he defined religion without philosophy is sentimentalism or sometimes fanaticism, while philosophy without religion is mental speculation. So therefore we should understand, so the all the problems they have their basis in philosophical problem or theological problem. So we should know the importance of cow protection in human society. So this is the first challenge. Ignorance is the first challenge. People don't know the importance of it. And economically how it is important, that also should be understood. Nowadays economics means it's all industrial economy it is. So produce unwanted things, advertise and sell them, and if you don't have money to buy, so government will print and give loan or distribute in the form of salary. So this is what is economics. But they don't realize what is required for human body. What we need economics? So, economics, what is that? Roti, kapda, kapda, makan in Hindi we say. So we need roti, kapda and makan, right? So we need food, we need some covering on the body, and we need some shelter. Of course, people want sense gratification. They want, they are very materialistic. So materialistic, we are materialistic in the sense that we want more and more and more sense gratification. So every day is craving out some new way of enjoying senses. So then you need to earn money. So but basic necessities if you consider, so roti, kapda, makan. So if cow milk is a most important food item, and so we can produce food grains with cow urine, cow dung, and cows also give bulls. So you don't need to have tractor, you don't need to import oil from Middle East and manufacture tractor and run the tractor. So you, with the help of bull power, you can produce food grains. So therefore cows are considered as mother and bulls are considered as father of human society. And in this way, we see that all our economic problems will be solved also. Prabhupada used to say, few acres of land and few cows. So all your economic problems are solved. So, but people don't, they don't want to be happy also. So this is all ignorance. So if you tell people, okay, grow some food and cook some food and eat and be happy, they will say, no, we will develop technology. They say that. So they think that by technological advance, by manufacturing technology, by developing technology, we become happy. So this is all ignorance, because in ignorance, Krishna says that right is wrong, wrong is right, truth is untruth, untruth is truth, dharma is adharma, adharma is dharma. In the 18th chapter of Bhagavad Gita, Krishna says. So what is luxury is discomfort, and discomfort is luxury. So this is all ignorance it is. And main challenges apart from this, this is common in all the problems facing cow protection, this philosophical problem. Then apart from that, the two main problems is land and labor. So land, previously, at least in India, maybe all over the world, there were specified pasturing lands were there. So in Hindi we call them, or in Sanskrit also, Gocharan Bhumi we say. So Hindi, Sanskrit. So in vernacular language there are different words for that. So there was specified land was there. Even today, in government, in India, in government record, so there is specified land is there for. So, but mostly it is all encroached and used for so many other purposes. So every time some rascal, demonic politician, in the election, he promises to people that I will, that encroached land I will make in your name. Like here in this area, they grow coffee, and all the forest land and all this, Gocharan Bhumi, this pasturing land they have encroached. And every time this politician election comes, this politician, just for the sake of vote, he will distribute that land to the encroached people. So even the so-called pro-Hindutva governments, the politicians also, they do these things in ignorance, because they don't know what they are doing actually. Like I saw this Mudigeri, one politician, in the election, in his election from manifesto or whatever promises they make. So that one promise was that I will make all the land, your copy land in your name. So that unregistered land which they encroached. So they are supposed to So they are supposed to protect the Deshwar. They, if they are pro-Hindutva or pro-Vedic, they are supposed to protect the interests of the cow protection, right? So that they don't know, because in ignorance they don't know that. So there is no pasturing land. That is a major problem, because if there is no land, cows become burden. They are economically liability. In fact, actually, cows maintain us. We don't need to maintain us, them actually. They maintain us. Economically, I'm talking. So we don't have to provide for them. They will provide for us. So what is the necessity of the cows? They will go out, graze on the land. Every year some rain comes. Even if little rain comes also, 7, 8 months there will be grass would be there until the end of February, at least here in India. So there would be grass, and they will graze on the grass, and they will give the most valuable thing in the entire universe, milk. So that is the most valuable thing in the entire. Even gold is not valuable. So people generally, they think that gold is valuable. So, or nowadays, you bank balance or some tin cars, maybe they may be thinking it as valuable. So they go out, graze some grass, or the agriculture waste they eat. सो वॉट इज देयर नीड नेसेसिटी एक्चुअली दे डोंट नीड मच सो बट टुडे बिकॉज देर इज नो लैंड काउज हैव बिकम इकोनॉमिकल लाइबिलिटी सो पीपल यू नो दोज आर मेंटेनिंग गोशालाज दे हैव टू कलेक्ट लॉट्स ऑफ डोनेशन सो यू डोंट नीड टू कलेक्ट डोनेशन फॉर इनफैक्ट कलेक्टिंग डोनेशन फॉर काउज actually encourages cow slaughter because it gives the impression or it gives the message that they are economically liable on us. In fact, they will maintain us by giving the best thing in the we call it as nectar, you know. So cow milk is nectar. They give us and they maintain us. So this problem, especially in India, it has been from a long-standing problem because this problem was artificially it was created by Britishers because they understood that cow protection is central to the Indian economy or Indian culture, Vedic culture. To break the Vedic culture, they created that situation. First of all, even the forest land was not controlled by the so controlled by government. Now it's all now forest land, they put a boundary and they don't allow cows to enter there. So much forest land, and most of the forest land like here in this area is all converted into coffee plantations. So there are so many issues. So in 1927, M.K. Gandhi, although his one of the contributions is to encourage cow slaughter, allow Muslims and Christians to slaughter cows. He was the one who gave permission because he wanted to be politically correct with the minorities. So because in politics there is always appeasement, what they call it as appeasement politics, to appeasing all the ignorant people, you know, demo, ignorant foolish people, so who don't know the goal of life. So in Young India in 90, there was a newspaper called Young India in 1927. So Gandhi gave some recommendations regarding cow protection. So he said state should maintain cow farms, he says. It seems that Prabhupada took the idea of farm community from Gandhi actually. It seems like that. Of course, he is a self-realized soul, all Vedic knowledge, Veda was in his heart. But there is a concept in Vedic parlance that Madhukari, you know, that concept of Madhukari. Madhukari means just like honey bee takes, you know, honey, nectar from different flowers. So a Paramahamsa, a liberated soul may take knowledge from here and there. So that is there, but that doesn't mean we should think that he is learning from some mundane politician. So, but anyway, that one point. So farm community, because this idea of farm community was actually pioneered by Srila Prabhupada, because previous acharyas it was not necessary, because India was already a agro-based economic country. So Vedic culture was still to large extent it was ext or Vedic economy was to large extent it was extant when previous acharyas were there. So as industrialization came, so it was necessary for acharya to initiate such programs to revive dharmic economy or dharmic economics. So he says that Gandhi said that so state should maintain the cow farms, he says. So basically land is required for cows. So there should be ample land. So now presently if you see the government in India at least, if you want to make a goshala, they will give you some tax exemption for that. But they should also allow to hold land actually, big pieces of land. Then there will be proper cow protection. अदरवाइज इट्स लाइक दिस गौशालाज आर जस्ट लाइक यू नो दे आर जेल्स, ओल्ड एज होम्स, जस्ट लाइक फॉर ह्यूमन बींग्स दे मेक ओल्ड एज होम्स. सो काउज शुड गो आउट ग्रेज एंड इट इकोनॉमिकली इट बिकम्स वेरी डिफिकल्ट टू मेंटेन. वी सी इन इंटरनेट ऑल द टाइम सम एडवर्टाइज कीप्स कमिंग, ओ प्लीज डोनेट फॉर काउ प्रोटेक्शन एंड ऑल दिस काइंड ऑफ थिंग्स. सो इन दिस वे ऑफकोर्स वन कैन डोनेट फॉर टू परचेज लैंड फॉर काउज डेफिनेटली, बिकॉज इफ गवर्नमेंट इज नॉट सेंक्शनिंग लैंड फॉर द काउ प्रोटेक्शन, सो एटलीस्ट दोज हु आर धार्मिक माइंडेड पीपल, दोज आर पायस पीपल, सो दे शुड डोनेट टू परचेज द लैंड एक्चुअली फॉर द काउज. एंड दिस प्रेजेंट गवर्नमेंट इन इंडिया, इट वॉज सपोज टू बी प्रो वैदिक, बट दे डोंट हैव आइडिया ऑफ ऑल दिस थिंग. दे आर प्रमोटिंग सो मच इंडस्ट्रियलाइजेशन, सो इंडस्ट्रियलाइजेशन इज काउ किलर एक्चुअली. सो इंडस्ट्रियलाइजेशन, एनी इंडस्ट्रियल अटेम्प्ट, बिकॉज एवरी गवर्नमेंट इट इन इफ यू सी इन द बजेट्स एवरी ईयर दे मेक बजेट्स, सो दे ऑलवेज ब्रिंग इंडस्ट्रियल एजेंडा. सो दिस गवर्नमेंट, पीपल बिलीव मेनी इन इंडिया दैट ओ दिस गवर्नमेंट इज वेरी प्रो हिंदू और प्रो वैदिक, बट एक्चुअली देयर पॉलिसीज आर ऑलवेज इंडस्ट्रियल डेवलपमेंट. डेवलपमेंट इज एक्चुअली बज वर्ड वी सी इन द नेम ऑफ दे आर दे केम टू पावर बाय डेवलपमेंट. एक्चुअली अंडरलाइंग sentiment was pro Hinduism, so they exploited that, but their main agenda is always development. Development, development means you know industrialization, so which is a cow slaughterer. So that is one thing. So second thing is, so third challenge is labor. So labor problem, why there is labor problem? Because again that industrial economics, people left cows and land, so land based economy. So then they all went to do job in the industries, so factories, industries, then they stopped doing cow production. So before we go to this point of labor, discussion of labor, we can discuss, I would like to discuss this point that how Krishna so he went to, from Mathura he went to Gokul, and when he was very young, so he started looking after, he started tending cows, small cows. So we see in the 10th canto chapter 11 text number 38, till this point Krishna was killing some demons and doing some childhood activities, playing around, scrolling, so giving pleasure to the residents of Vrindavan. So verse number 37 actually. So we see एवं व्रजौकसां प्रीतिं यच्छन्तो बालचेष्टितये कलवाक्यै स्वकालेन वत्सपालो बभूवतुः. इन दिस वे कृष्ण एंड बलराम एक्टिंग लाइक स्मॉल बॉयज एंड टॉकिंग इन अ हाफ ब्रोकन लैंग्वेज गेव ट्रांसेंडेंटल प्लेजर टू ऑल द इनहैबिटेंट्स ऑफ व्रजा. In due course of time, swakalena vatsapalo babuvatuhu, it is said here. In due course of time, they became old enough to take care of cows. Cows, how old enough? At the age of, Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur says, at the age of 3 years. At the age of 3, they started taking care of cows. Of course, those days people used to be physically strong also. Now in Kali Yuga, hardly Because just you see here, it is, you know, they were not even able to talk properly, half broken language it is, you know. So therefore Vishnu Chakravarti Thakur says, so at the age of 3, they started taking care of cows. So Prabhupada, he says, as soon as Krishna and Balaram were little grown up, they were meant for taking care of the cows. Although born of a very well-to-do family, they still had to take care of the cows. Now it is a prestige issue. If you are taking care of cows, you are considered a low class. If you are going to school, reading, writing, you are considered as very civilized. And nowadays, if somebody is doing farming and cow production, they don't give even girls to them to get married, actually. You need to have a big job. You need to be earning money. You should have a big degree. Huh? Big degree. In India, at least, this is the situation. So, but here in well-to-do family, they still had to take care of the cows. So, this was the system of education. Actually, I have seen in my childhood, doing job was considered low class, actually. So farming and cow production was considered. Why we should go and work under someone? People had this sense of prestige, sense of, self-respect. Now there is nothing self-respect. They have some concocted idea of self-respect. This was the system of education. Those who were not born in Brahmin families were not meant for academic education. Here we come to point. Why there is labor problem? One of the point is mass education is also cow killer, actually. So why it is cow killer? Mass education is connected with industrial economics, economy. The whole purpose of education is what? You go and get a job and earn money, actually. That's what they teach in education. So forget about spiritual knowledge. Like in Bhagavad Gita, Krishna defines knowledge in 13th chapter, verse number 8 to 12. So he says that knowledge means to realize birth, death, old age, and disease, and to solve them, definitely. So if knowledge which does not help us to solve the problems of life, birth, what is the use of this knowledge, actually? What is the use of this education which doesn't help us to solve the problems of birth, death, old age, and disease? So spiritually, from liberation, from the point of liberation from material bondage, this is useless education. But even from materialistic point of view, material point of view also, we see that this education is, I sometime in my lectures I tell that it's a training to create labor for industrial civilization, a society actually. Education means make labors for industrial society. So then all this banking and currency system they have made, because unless this currency and banking system which they are running now, you can't run industrial society, because if unwanted things are produced, people have to purchase. They need some means of exchange for that, to purchase that. They need purchasing power. To support that, then they have to make up this cheating currency system, actually, which is completely a cheating. Now this government was, Modi government was trying to control, what is that, bribe, what is it, say? So bribe, no, what is that? Corruption, sorry, corruption, that word I was not. So they are trying to control corruption, corruption, corruption. But your whole economy, the very currency system itself is a corrupt system, actually. Why you are talking all this hypocrisy, full hypocrisy? So I am not targeting Mr. Modi ji. At least maybe his ideas are good. But point is, this whole system, currency system, banking system itself is a corrupt system. Then why you expect that people to be very that they are not engaged in corruption? So mass education is meant for taking out people from land and cow based economy and put them in industrial economy. So traditionally, here it is, Prabhupada says, this is the system of, this was the system of education. Those who were not born in Brahmin families were not meant for academic education. So Brahmanas were trained in a literary academic education, Kshatriyas were trained to take care of state, and the Vaishyas learned how to cultivate the land and take care of the cows and calves. There was no need to waste time going to school to be falsely educated and later increase the number of unemployed. You see what a so what a purport it is. Krishna and Balaram taught us by their personal behavior. Krishna took care of cows and played his flute, and Balaram took care of agriculture activities with a plow in his hand. So here we see Prabhupada, he spoke about Varnashrama colleges. Prabhupada, he said every ISKCON center should be a Varnashrama college. So training people in according to their propensities. Why, we will discuss that more in about Varnashrama college. So here the point is that Vaishya and Shudra children, from the beginning of their life, they were contributing into family and social economics from the beginning of their life. Kshatriya boys would be learning all martial arts, dhanurvidya. Then Brahmanas would study everything, including agriculture, cow protection, everything they have to study and guide the society. So Brahmana boys. So in this way, society was very nicely organized. Now there are so many misconceptions about this Varnashrama system among the broader society, in the broader society and among devotees also. So they don't have clue. It's all ignorance basically. So often we do bhakti in ignorance. Basically, we don't know actually what we are doing. So they don't know this Varnashrama system, how it is important for human society. So this is foolish idea that actually just by coming to a Krishna consciousness and just chanting, murmuring some names, we become Paramahamsas immediately. It's possible, it's not impossible, but it's not reality for most of the people in this world. We need to eat, we need to sleep, we need to mate. So then we have to regulate those things, therefore dharma is required. So that's why Grahastasram. Prabhupada did not allow hippies to remain hippies and chant Hare Krishna. He said, boys and girls, they were staying together as friends in one room. He said, no, you should get married, he said. He introduced Grahastasrama. Ashrama means part of Varnashrama. But most of the people, they don't understand these basic things actually. They say, why Varnashrama? So Prabhupada wanted this education system should be like this. So this mass education is a cow slaughterer. Why? Because, and it's a foolishness. Why? Because first of all, governments of the world, most of the governments of the world, they cannot give free education. And that has become a big business industry now. So education is a big money-making industry, it is. And people are exploited. Then after that, some or other struggle and get some job, get some degree, and end result is what? Unemployment. So in second canto of Bhagavatam, Prabhupada very heavily in one purport. So he says that this education is producing dogs, he says, going from one door to another begging for job, he says. So in this way, we see that then unemployment. Result of this education is unemployment. So just like in Bhagavatam, Prahlad, he said that Varamod Bhavato Vimudan. This Vimuda, Muda means rascals and foolish people. This Vimuda means very, very, very merry, means highest degree, rascals. they take unnecessary burden of the world. So what we mean by this? That government cannot give first free education, but it pushes for education, 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 education. So then after that they cannot provide jobs, employment. So that is another. So like this, take the burden of the world, people. Just engage them in land and cow protection. They are so labor intensive. Cow protection and land are so for agriculture are so much labor intensive. Of course, everything is a labor intensive. So much labor intensive that any amount of labor, you know, people can be employed there. So there is no unemployment problem at all. But it's out of ignorance. Out of ignorance, government wants to take the burden of education and giving employment. Now most of the leaders of the world, before they get elected, they have to promise to people that I will create so much, thousands and thousands of employment. Everyone comes to power by promising employment. So job, 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 job. What a nonsense thing to do, actually. We discuss like in Vedic culture, people would not even think about their food, shelter, clothing, where I will get food, where I will get, all the time planning. Of course, it's not just food and they want sense gratification. Therefore, always planning for money, 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 money-based economy. So in this way, people are always... So there is a chaos. This is a social unrest, actually it is. Although people may not realize in ignorance, it's a social unrest. There is no peace. There is no... Always people are burning in anxiety. What will be my future? What will be my career? So burning in anxiety. So what to speak of liberation, attaining, liberation. So the basic material happiness they will not get. If they are always in anxiety, for money, 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 money. So, sometime I tell Darwinism is true in context with modern society. They are hunting for money and gathering food and eating. So, of course, they commercially grow food also. So, in this way, means according to Darwin, previously people were hunter-gatherers. So, that point I am trying to apply to modern society. So they are hunting for money and gathering food and eating. So in this socio-economic system, there cannot be peace and happiness. Of course, ultimately there is no material happiness in the world. It's a place of suffering and misery, but whatever relatively peaceful life, relative material happiness, good food, good health, peace of mind. So that is, relatively it is not there. So in this way, mass education is also cow slaughterer. Because children at the age of Vaishya and Shudra children, who are supposed to be, it's not that by giving education we are doing benefit to them actually, but it's an exploitation. Ultimately, not only children are exploited, the whole world is exploited. It will have to, right? We have to rejoin the movement or something. We don't know what to do. I think we have to again restart more meeting, I think, no? Yeah, so meeting is going to war, so we'll again restart it. So anyway, the point is that ultimately everyone would be exploited. So is it a comfortable thing working in the night, night shifts? Those who are working in the land, they don't need to work in the night. They can go and after a day's hard work. So like this propaganda is there against farming and cow production, that it's a very hard labor. But working in the night is not a comfortable thing actually. So therefore Prabhupada used to call technology as Ugra Karma. He didn't say farming as Ugra Karma. Ugra Karma is a word in 16th chapter of Bhagavad Gita. Krishna says that demons are engaged in Ugra Karma. It's a demonic society. because this technology, people in illusion, in ignorance, they think that it is comfort and luxury, but actually it is Ugra Karma, because working in night is not a comfortable thing actually. So Ugra Karma means severe, painful jobs, endeavors. So in this way, we see that people are engaged in Ugra Karma. So ultimately they are exploited. It's not by making people to earn money and get a job and earn money, is we are not doing benefit to them actually. Instead, if they are in farming and cowherd, they will get good food, good health, good body, good sound mind. They will be more happy. So this mass education and industrial economy is again is a cow slaughterer. That is the main reason. But here the point we are talking about, so I'll come back to this Varnashrama college point, Varnashrama. Now another point comes here is child labor actually. So by engaging children, small children in cow production, you are so you are engaging them in child labor, they say. So, but if you see in United Nations or International Organization for Child Labor or whatever labor organization website, if you see, there are 152 million child laborers in the world, according to today's statistics. But this is, I say, this is just a labor. This is just what is reported. I generally, most of the things are double than what is reported. So there may be millions and millions more child laborers. So my point is that you cannot stop child labor. It is impossible. So I challenge to all the governments in the world and all the international organizations like United Nations organization and all the charitable institutions, all social workers, whoever, humanity, philanthropists, that you stop child labor and show to me. It is not, it is impossible. Why? What is the logic behind my conviction? Logic behind my conviction is that Vedic economy was most stable economy, and it was highly regulated, because dharma means regulation. So very highly regulated. Why I am talking about regulation in economics? Because you just go on producing unwanted things, you know. Like you see, go to any showroom. So many hundreds and hundreds of pairs of shoes, hundreds and hundreds, thousands, sorry, thousand, or in fact millions, you can say. Or lakhs and lakhs and lakhs of shoes, lakhs and lakhs of sets of clothes, automobiles, two-wheelers. Why produce unnecessarily? If you don't need, don't produce. Don't produce. Traditionally in Vedic society, so that chamar class used to be there. Chamar, you understand that? What does that say? Cobblers. Yeah, cobbler class used to be there. You order them whenever you need, and then he will make and give you. No need of stocking. No stocking. So unnecessary. So it was highly regulated. In such highly regulated socio-economic system, there was child labor. Of course, I am not talking this child labor, and you cannot apply it to Vaishyas and Shudra children, because child labor is exploitation. Like I mentioned, everyone is exploited in modern society. We can't apply this word child labor to Vedic society, in one sense I am saying. So anyway, children were contributing in economics. So that is not possible in That is not possible. So in modern society, which is so, modern socio-economic system is so highly unregulated, you need labor. So their children would be engaged in labor. इफ यू वॉन्ट यू सी हाउ मेजर मेजर इंडस्ट्री वेयर चिल्ड्रन आर एंगेज इन इज चॉकलेट इंडस्ट्री. यू कैन गूगल गूगल चॉकलेट्स एंड चाइल्ड लेबर, यू विल सी दैट हाउ मिलियंस ऑफ चिल्ड्रन आर एंगेज इन मेकिंग नॉट चॉकलेट्स. सो पीपल एंजॉय, दे मे बी ऑल द स्टार्स सेलिब्रिटीज, दे मे बी वन साइड दे मे बी गिविंग सम चैरिटी, स्प्रिंकलिंग सम मनी फॉर सम सोशल फिलोथ्रॉपिकल एक्टिविटीज. अदर साइड दे एडवर्टाइज यू नो ईटिंग चॉकलेट्स. यू ईट चॉकलेट देन यू विल बिकम वेरी हैप्पी. दे अर्न मनी थ्रू दैट बाय एंडोर्सिंग चॉकलेट्स. सो इन दैट वे दे आर प्रमोटिंग चाइल्ड लेबर. सो इट इज़ क्लोज टू इम्पॉसिबल टू स्टॉप चाइल्ड लेबर. सो देयर फॉर नो नीड ऑफ दिस होल सो कॉल्ड मास एजुकेशन एंड नॉन सेंस. एक्चुअली यू डोंट हैव टू हिपोक्र दिस इज ऑल हिपोक्रेसी. सो बेटर फॉलो वैदिक वैदिक इकोनॉमिक्स एंड वैदिक एजुकेशन. सो वैदिक एजुकेशन इज वर्णाश्रम कॉलेज प्रभुपाद सेड दैट. सो गुरुकुल एजुकेशन बिकॉज नॉट एवरी वन विल बी ओनली वन क्लास ब्राह्मण क्लास. नाउ लाइक आई एम डिस्कसिंग अबाउट चैलेंजेस इन काउ प्रोटेक्शन टुडे. देर आर चैलेंजेस इन रनिंग गुरुकुल. मोस्ट ऑफ आवर डिवोटीज दे थिंक दैट एवरी वन माई चाइल्ड ऑल्सो हैज टू बिकम अ ग्रेट पंडित. देर आर चैलेंजेस इन रनिंग गुरुकुल. दैट इज अनदर बिग टॉपिक एक्चुअली टू बी डिस्कस्ड. सो दैट माई सन इज लाइक अ मोस्ट सेंटली पर्सन. माई सन इज द बेस्ट. दिस इज शुक्राचार्य मेंटेलिटी. माई सेमन इज द बेस्ट सेमन. शुक्र आचार्य. शुक्र मीन्स सेमन. सो सेमिनल लीनिएज. सो माई चाइल्ड इज लाइक कृष्णा ओनली. ही इज सो स्वीट एंड ब्यूटिफुल इन एवरी वे लाइक दैट यू थिंक. सो एवरी वन विल नॉट बी पंडित्स. सो वेरी फ्यू वुड बी देयर आउट ऑफ 100 मे बी वन चाइल्ड. सो अदर चिल्ड्रन शुड बी अकॉर्ड एंड दे विल बी हैप्पी डूइंग दैट. इफ यू पुट देम लाइक इन मॉडर्न एजुकेशन they don't want to be engineer, they don't want to be doctor, but they are forced because of social pressure. So they are forced and no one is happy learning whatever they are doing. So just be happy. We want happy people in society. Among devotees we want happy devotees, happy devotee children. So just be happy. So but that doesn't mean that brahmanas will not do cow protection. So in Vedic culture everyone will do cow protection. So like you see that, so kshatriyas, kings used to donate cows to the brahmanas because I told no, there will be no religious activity without cows. Everyone cow protection is a must. It is, if you want to lead a religious life, dharmic life, you need cows. It is impossible. So without dharma there is no question of neither material progress nor spiritual progress. There is no question of progress. So we will only degrade and just suffer and die, that's all. So brahmanas would protect cows, kshatriyas would protect cows, because if they are donating it to brahmanas then they need cow, right? Lots of protection. Like in Mahabharata we see that in 1 year Pandavas were in incognito and Nakula was taking care of one of them, Nakula and Sahadeva. One was taking care of horses, royal horse, stab, and Sahadeva was taking care of cows. And they have written books on cow protection. Sahadeva wrote cow protection book on Go Shastra, something, Go Raksha Shastra or something. And he wrote Ashwa Shastra. Nakula wrote. So they were protecting, and we see that Duryodhana and company, they came and took away the cows, kidnapped the cows, and then the fight started. So kings used to maintain huge goshalas. Then in Gurukulas there would be Goshala in Brahmanical setup. Temples used to maintain Goshalas. Brahmanas used to keep cows, although they may not go out to tend them, but so some Shudra will, one man would be in every village, there would be a man who would take them out and bring them evening back. So they would engage the Shudras to do that. So, but they will protect cows. Then Vaishyas, their main function is that, protection of cows and farming. Then there are Shudras also will keep cows. Everyone will keep cows, literally. That is human society. You can imagine. It is discussed in some time in the history, the population of the cows in India was 10 times the more than the population of human beings, sometime in the history. That may vary time to time, definitely. So now I don't know, they say that it's 1 out of 100 people or something like that. So I don't know the statistics, I didn't do the homework. So, but everyone will protect the cows. So in that way, a whole human society was engaged in cow protection. So everyone was engaged in cow protection. There is nothing, there is no life without cows. That's all. So, in this way, Krishna took care of cows and played his. These are two major. Then they cry out so many other things. So there is no rain. Rain helps the cows. So if you don't protect cows, then where rain will come? It's directly connected, right? So there may be other issues, but these are the major challenges facing cow protection. Then. So one thing is that and this industrial not only cow. It was people when they go out and hunt and kill means kill and it's a big endeavor, right? So no one would like to do that. So now it's easily available, throw money, get for meat from the slaughterhouse and gobble it. So you're so easily available. So like the previous government, Congress government, so in 2012 or 13 they made 12th or 13th 5 year plan. They have Panchavarshiya Yojana, 5 year plans. So they wanted to do, they did, what is that? They announced a pink revolution. So there was green revolution, then there was white revolution, then there was blue revolution. Blue revolution means all these fish ponds they started in, especially in Andhra area, the greatest contribution of our Andhra, ex-Andhra CM, converting all the great paddy lands in that those coastal area, that all this East Godavari area, such a great paddy land, so much water, so much. So in those places, so he may convert thousands and thousands of acres of land into fish ponds. Nonsense, completely. And that, oh, that Balaji temple money, they used it for such activities. So this is all nonsense. These demonic demons, all politicians. Prabhupada used this term actually for politicians. In the first canto, if you read. So they are demons. So this Congress government, they announced pink revolution. So upgrading all the slaughterhouses, mechanizing them and storing facilities, freezing facilities, export facilities, and kill lots of animals. So one of our devotee, he wrote, what 1,000 years of Muslim rule rulers could not do, and what 200 years of British rulers could not do, this one lady from Italy did in 5 years or 10 years, whatever. One of our devotees, Sahadeva Prabhu, temple president of Sikandarabad, he has written lots of books on cow. So we should distribute those books. So in this way, these cow slaughters have to be closed also. So Varnashrama college means all, everyone would be engaged. And if there is no Varnashrama Dharma, there cannot be co-protection. That is another thing actually. That's why Prabhupada wanted Varnashrama colleges. Because in dharmic society only people will understand the importance of cause, them, right? So if there is no dharmic society, there is no question of. Nowadays our devotees also, they want to do jobs, you know, earn money, lots of money. They think that this is comfortable life, luxurious. And we can chant Krishna's names in a very transcendental way. This is all imagination, actually. So, we often earn money by serving cows, lot of killers, actually, beef eaters, lechers. Like Rupa Sanatan Goswami, they submitted in front of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu saying that we have become betrayers of cows and Vedic civilization, they said. Why they are betrayers of cows and Vedic? Because they are serving these Muslim kings who are cow killers. We see that, I think in ISKCON main donation comes from Middle East, I think. Serving all these cow killing Muslims and earning money. I heard somebody has written a book called Easy Journey to Goloka. Sitting in Bahrain, earning some money, and he is thinking of going to. So even if you chant Hare Krishna, in ignorance if you chant Hare Krishna, will not get purified. Okay, result will be there, but the result will get in a very, after long, 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 maybe we don't know how many births we will get actually. So if you do it based on knowledge, then that's why Krishna says Buddhi Yoga in Bhagavad Gita. So we won't make progress. So in Chaitanya Charitamrita, he says, Bahu janma jadi kore shavana kirtana thabutana paaye Krishna pada premadana. So even after many, many, many lifetimes, in the translation actually Prabhupada uses millions of lifetimes, if you chant Hare Krishna, will not get love of Godhead. Because if in ignorance if you do, we should know what is what. What is right, what to do, what not to do, based on Shastra. These are all basic things which are discussed in Bhagavad Gita, but most of the people, they don't learn Bhagavad Gita. Mostly, I think they are just some stories from Bhagavad Gita. Classes must be stories from Bhagavatam or something like that. Anyway, today is Gopastami. So, I'll read more from then. Abidure vraja buvaha saha gopala darakhai charayam asatur vatsan nana krida parichadau. So they were just 3 years old, all the covered by Krishna and Balaram, and they took other of their friends who were of the same age, maybe sometime little more than them. So and playfully they would take care of the cows. Not far away from their residential quarters, both Krishna and Balaram, equipped with all kinds of playthings, played with other cowherd boys and began to tend the small cows. So they would be taking care of cows and simultaneously playing, doing their childhood activities. So what are the playthings, what they were doing? Kvachit vadayato venum kshepanai kshipata kvachit kvachit padaik kankini bihi kvachit kritrima go vrashai vrashayamano nardanthau yuyudhate parasparam anukritya rutair jantum cheratu prakritau yata. Sometimes Krishna and Balaram would play on their flutes. Sometimes they would throw ropes and stones devised for getting fruits from the tree. Sometimes they would throw only stones, and sometimes their ankle bells tinkling, they would play football with fruits like bale and amalaki. So they would always, they will also, this also means they would eat amalaki, amla, gooseberry. Sometimes they would cover themselves with blankets and winded cows and bulls and fight with one another, roaring loudly, and sometimes they would imitate the voices of the animals. In this way, they enjoyed sporting exactly like two ordinary human children. So this is what they were doing, playing. And if you compare this play with the present day children playing, what they are playing. What is that? PUBG? What is that? PUBG. Playing on the mobile. Nonsense. Completely. It's such a suffering it is. Although the children may be liking it, but actually it is suffering. Children would be so happy doing what Krishna. This is called Krishna Krida. There is a book written by one of our devotees. So he has written a book called Krishna Krida for children to learn this. So, and all these things are not possible in the cities actually. So it's not possible. If children, you want to bring up children in cities, so this Krishna Krida is not possible, right? But Vrindavan is full of peacocks. Kujata kokila hamsa sarak gana kirne mayurakule. Vrindavan is full of our peacocks. Present Vrindavan is full of automobiles, and it has become a cement jungle now, thanks to all the neophytes who went and settled there. So that's why in the Shastra it is said, neophytes should not go more than 3 days to the holy places. We will only spoil the holy places. That will be our contribution. Instead of going and doing austerities there. Vrindavan forest is always full of cuckoos, ducks, swans, peacocks, cranes, and also monkeys, bulls and cows. So Krishna and Balaram used to imitate the sounds of these animals and enjoy sporting. So this natural beauty is lost even in dams. Kali Yuga influence of Kali we see. Actual dam cannot be covered by Kali, but because Krishna wants to cheat all unfortunate, misguided, we can say, devotees. Because of course non-devotees also go there. They are also going there for sinful and materialistic activities. And we are all misguided devotees actually. So to cheat us, then Krishna covers real dham with all these materialistic things. And people think that, oh, I am in dham and all these things. So sometime our own temples are making apartments and selling them in the dham also. So these are all disservice to holy dham actually. So Vrindavan forest is full of cuckoos. Kadachit Yamuna Tire Vatsam Sharayatasvakai Ayastai Krishna Balayor Jigamshur Daitya Agamat. One day while Rama and Krishna along with their playmates were tending the cows on the bank of river Yamuna, then another demon came. This is Vatsasura. So this is at the age of 3, Krishna started taking care of cows. But then when he became, after 3 years, when he became 6, then he started taking care of bigger cows. So that is the day, that the day is come up, so is Gopastami today. So that is discussed in the 15th chapter of 10th canto of Bhagavatam. Sri Shuka Uvacha Tatascha Paugundavayah Shrito Vraje बभूवतस्थौ पशुपालसम्मतौ गाश्चारयन्तौ सखिभिः समं पदे वृन्दावनं पुण्यमतीव चक्रतुः. श्री सुखदेव गोस्वामी सेड व्हेन लॉर्ड राम एंड कृष्णा, सो बलराम इज ऑफन कॉल्ड विद द नेम राम, सो अटेन द एज ऑफ पौगुंडा, दैट इज 6, सो बिटवीन 6 टू 10 इज कॉल्ड एज Pagunda. While living in Vrindavan, the covered men allowed them to take up the task of tending cows. Engaging thus in the company of their friends, the two boys rendered the land of Vrindavan most auspicious by imprinting upon it the marks of their lotus feet. So then they started tending the cows. So here BBT purport. Lord Krishna wanted to encourage his coward boyfriends who had been swallowed by Agasura and then stolen by Lord Brahma. Therefore, the Lord decided to bring them into the farm tree forest called Thalavana, where there were many delicious ripe fruits. Since Lord Krishna's spiritual body had apparently grown slightly in age and strength, the senior men of Vrindavan, headed by Nanda Maharaj, decided to promote Krishna from the task of herding cows to the status of a regular cowherd boy. Gopa, he became Gopastami. He would now take care of the full-grown cows, bulls and oxen. Out of great affection, Nanda Maharaj had previously considered Krishna too small and immature to take care of full-grown cows and bulls. It is stated in the Kartika Mahatmya, because of Padma Purana, section of the Padma Purana. Padma Purana has a big section called Kartika Mahatmya, glories of Kartik, because this Gopastami comes in Kartik. So it is mentioned about this Gopastami there. Shuklastami Kartike to. So in the month of Kartika, Shukla Paksha, now this is Shukla Paksha, the second half of Kartik is called Shukla Paksha, and before that is Krishna Paksha. So Shuklastami Kartike tu Smrita Gopastami Budhaye Taddina Vasudevo Budh Gopapurvam tu Vatsapaha. Smrita, those who are learned, they call it as Gopastami Budhaye, intelligent people. Taddinad Vasudevo Budh. So on that day, Vasudeva, Krishna, Gopapurvam tu Vatsapaha. So he became a Gopa. Before he was Vatsapaha. Vatsapaha, Vatsapala. Gopala and Vatsapala. There are two words. So Vatsapala means one who takes care of small cows. The eighth lunar day of the bright fortnight of the month of Kartika is known by the authorities as Gopastami. From the day, Lord Vasudeva served as cowherd, whereas previously he had tended the cows. There are no words for Vatsapala and Gopala in English. The word Padai indicates that Lord Krishna blessed the earth by walking on her surface with his lotus feet. So he would not wear even shoes. We are discussing about shoes. The Lord wore no shoes or other foot gear, but walked barefoot in the land, in the forest, giving great anxiety to the girls of Vrindavan, who feared that his soft lotus feet would be injured. So like that it goes on. Tanmadava venum udarayan vrato gopar granadbihi svayasho balanvitaha pashun puraskritya pasvya avishad vihartu kama kusumakaram vanam. Thus desiring to enjoy the pastimes, Lord Madhava, sounding his flute, surrounded by cowherd boys who were chanting his glories, and accompanied by Lord Baladeva, kept the cows before him and entered the Vrindavan forest, which was full of flowers and rich with nourishment for the animals. So here, there are different words. So Pashavam, Puraskritya Prashavan, Avishat. Avishat means entered. Vihartu Kamaha, Kusumakaram Vanam. So Kusumakaram Vanam, so the forest full of rich flowers. Even when Prabhupada was there, if you hear Prabhupada lectures in Vrindavan, we can see the sound of chirping birds, sound of peacocks. Prabhupada would sit below that tree, which is still there in the courtyard of Vrindavan, Krishna Balaram temple. You would, that Kadamba tree was there below that, Tamal tree. So Prabhupada would sit below that and give lectures. So many lectures are recorded. You can see that sound of birds. chirping and all these things. So now today is only sound of automobile. And there is no place for cows. That's the main thing. We are today's topic is about cow production. There is no place for cows in both Mayapur and Vrindavan. It's all buildings, automobiles, roads, everywhere they are making more big roads now. So there are no place for cows. Okay, like this description goes on. Very nice description. 10th canto of Bhagavatam. You all can relish. Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Any questions, comments, long class?
So all this degradation happening due to Kali effect only or people ignorance, what we can attribute?
So the question is whether this degradation is happening because of the influence of Kali or people's ignorance. Actually, symptoms of the Kali, how we divide these ages actually. So, Satya Yuga, Treta Yuga, Dwapara Yuga, Kali Yuga. It's according to the modes. Modes means qualities. Everything is measured according to the qualities. So now, mode of ignorance becomes prominent in Kali Yuga. That is what is Kali Yuga means actually. So Satya Yuga was dominated by Satvaguna. So then Treta Yuga, Satvaguna got mixed with passion, and Dwapara Yuga is full of passion, and then Kali Yuga is full of ignorance, Tamaguna. So it's Kali Yuga. But if you want to extend your question, just because it is Kali Yuga, we can't contribute, we should not contribute in that, right? And we should not be swayed away by that. So in the first canto of Bhagavatam, if you see, Parikshit Maharaj stopped Kali. So Kali requested him and he cheated him basically. He said, you go to place, you can reside in a place where there is meat eating, gambling, illicit sex and intoxication, these four sinful activities. But Kali, then he searched everywhere and he did not find any one place where there is such sinful activity happening in the kingdom of Parikshit Maharaj. And this Kali, Parikshit kingdom was not just some India what we see today actually. It even extended beyond this earth actually. So Parikshit's kingdom was, he didn't find one, such was the kingdom, great kingdom actually. So we want to, and there in the one of the purports in the first canto of Bhagavatam, Prabhupada gives example that if it is raining, that doesn't mean we should get wet, you know, go and drench ourselves. No, we have to use the umbrella. So with the help of Krishna consciousness, we are supposed to protect ourselves from the influence of the Kali age. Protection, we are not even trying to protect actually, in fact we are contributing in Kali's progress actually. That is a tragedy of our devotees actually. Forget about protecting ourselves. Of course, if you protect yourself, then if you protect dharma, that is there, no? That was dharma rakshati rakshitaha. So if you protect dharma, then it will protect you. So we don't follow dharma, means we think that just do some worship in the morning, murmur some names. Dharma means our whole existence should be completely religious. It should become dharmic actually. Our earning, our livelihood, our education, our everything actually. Our thought, our behavior, everything. Our clothes, our eating. So that's the point. Dharma means it's not. In today's India, dharma means you do some puja and break some coconut and you feel. And he becomes very religious actually. So that's not dharma, is a bigger, it's a whole lifestyle it is actually, it's a way of life. So and in the 9th canto of Bhagavatam, Prabhupada, he says that about Lord Rama, there are two chapters, Ramayana is described in just two chapters in 9th canto. In one of the, that verse says that although it was Treta Yuga, because of the rule of Lord Rama, Rama Rajya, so it appeared like it was Satya Yuga. So in the purport, Prabhupada says, even in this Kali Yuga, we can, by introducing Sankirtan and Varnashram Dharma, Prabhupada says. By introducing Sankirtan and Varnashram, we can bring back Satyuga within this Kali Yuga. So, we have to do. We can't say, oh, it's Kali Yuga and sit. And, forget about saving the world. We ourselves will not be able to save us. Right? Our mission is to save the whole world by this Krishna consciousness movement, right?
We
ourselves
are
drawing. Yeah. So we are responsible. Yes. Yeah, Kali is there, but we have to stop it, no, right? He is not more powerful than Krishna, no? Kali is not more powerful than Krishna, right? He is not more powerful than Hare Krishna mantra, right? Maya is not more powerful than Krishna, right? We have to surrender to Krishna. Krishna will empower us. Then you may say, oh, why Krishna is not doing? Why he is not stopping Kali? He can stop within a moment, then what he will do? You don't want to serve Krishna? In Kurukshetra, he engaged Arjuna to fight. Arjuna wanted Krishna to fight and kill. Anyway, he said, I'll kill. Anyway, I have killed them, he said. Ultimately, Krishna only does, but we have to become instrument, right? For that, we have to surrender to Krishna. And Krishna will empower us. So this topic of surrender has to be discussed. Otherwise, this love, compassionate, it just becomes sham. It is. Anything else?
Prabhupada says, for me, he is a noble person.
Noblest occupation. Noblest occupation is. But that also has become corrupt now. All this chemical farming, commercial farming, and they put a lot of chemicals.
Now farmers are succeeding
there. They are victims actually, basically. This money culture and all this, you know, job, money. And they think that if you have a house in city, they are just waiting to jump to cities. They have given this whole idea of progress, development, they are indoctrinated actually. Everyone is. Whether they are studied in school or not, everyone is indoctrinated with that idea that, oh, if you upgrade yourself to urban setup and industrial job setup and earning money, then you are civilized human being. It's a nonsense. This whole idea of progress is a nonsense thing. It's a old church dogma, it is. Because Saint Augustine, one of the founding fathers of Catholic Church, so he said that. So every civilization is a progress from the previous one. But actually, Vedic, if you see Vedic Puranic histories, so this Kali Yuga is worst of all the ages. We are degrading, we are not making progress. So this whole church dogma, Darwin, he gave it some scientific color in the name of evolution to the same old church dogma. It just came from his cultural conditioning as a Christian actually. It's not a scientific theory at all actually. Okay, so we'll stop here then. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama. Srila Prabhupada ki jai, Gopashtami ki jai, Shri Gopal Bhagavan ki jai. Hare Krishna.